answer like why I started writing, you know, from far back.
My uncle and all his friends are in my laundry room. I go downstairs and his boy passes me a white can.
My babysitter was a graffiti writer and he gave me my first throw up.
Basically, he had an older brother that was doing graffiti, could piece, you know, got head ups, was, you know, it was involved in that.
I mean, it was just a natural thing. Everybody in high school was doing it. In high school, they were doing it. You were always around it. You couldn't really avoid it.
And he's like, go do whatever you want. So I go behind the building, I draw a little house, I draw a flower, and then I write Brat.
It's like all little kids, I was just obsessed with writing my name, my nickname.
My bro Cito, he's the one that actually got me into it, you know, because he was into it already, so he kept pushing me, like, yo, come on here. You know, so eventually I just started putting all my tag up.
It was, you know, part of growing up.
Cease, I need you at that corner right there, look, over there, standing by that tree. That tree over there.
Go, nigga, go.
Four or five years before I started, looking at that seven line, I had all my favorites on there. I would go to school with such a big smile every time there was a fucking Ghost or MQ battle. That shit got me fucking like, wow, what is this? When did they do this? What time do they do this? How do they do this? That's what made graffiti so exciting to me.
At first you start writing because it's something to do, like it's more of a sport, you know.
I know there's so many different factors. It's just the obvious thing to do because it's just there, you know. It's a constant influence on everyone, even if you don't want it to be. You know?
Depending on my mood, if I'm mad, sad, whatever, like if I'm just mad, whatever, I'll just go bomb. I'll come home, I'll be good.
Seeing like my name, seeing my progression, even seeing my regression. Sometimes I'm like, wow, like stop drinking, Brat. Like.
What truly motivates you to paint in the streets?
That's it. It's just a stress relief.
I just love it, you know? I just love art, so that's me expressing myself, you know? Like, I do it for the love, you know? Like,
just the adrenaline and just looking up at it after I was done, like, I got away with it.
I think the act, like, just doing it and just seeing what you've created, you know, out in the world and also other people seeing it, and if they take enjoyment from it, that's even better.
I write graffiti for many, many reasons. Many reasons. But it obviously is passion. If you're taking risks without a financial reward, that's passion. I risk everything every time I go out there.
Adrenaline, man, that's what I like, man. I'm on a bus, you know, I'm already on the spot, I'm just doing it, I'm just getting out, you know, I'm walking home. That's all I like feeling. I like going home and just sleeping all day. Fucking wake up, gotta go to work.
When I was younger, I was motivated to paint. Yeah, I wanna like do something dope. I wanna paint. Like, I'm gonna do this character, I'm gonna do this spot. Like, this is cool. But now I got older now and I'm just like, I don't really have the motivation. One, why? Because it's just graffiti, and it's just like, and if you're not consistent with graffiti, nobody cares about you. And if you are consistent, you end up getting arrested.
And it's my own personal satisfaction because I love walking by or seeing it up somewhere. Like, I remember the story behind that.
Like do harm to themselves or abuse drugs and shit like that. I fucking do graffiti because I feel like I'm not hurting anyone. I'm just going up. I'm going out, putting my fucking name up. You know, it's illegal to the cops, to society. It's because how society sees graffiti. But yeah, I mainly do graffiti because it's an escape from all the bullshit. From reality, you know, like, you know, for a little bit, I feel alive when I'm doing graffiti. I feel, you know, I'm a different person. Like in the during the day, I'm this kid who just, you know, smokes a lot of weed, goes to school. Then at night, I'm this motherfucker who was in your backyard, and you ain't even fucking know it.
As long as you can see from that way, this way.
Okay.
Me and my niggas, we the best. We the best, yo. You come to the city, you come to New York City, NYC, you wanna fuck with the best, you gotta fuck with me and my niggas. I'm talking about, when I say the best, I'm talking about BBB, FFF, R2B, TSK, ASR, you feel me? Like, BMG, you feel me? WTP, crews like that, like, this is literally our fucking city. Like, soon as you get off the fucking plane, JFK, LaGuardia, soon as you get off the bus, fucking 42nd Street, fucking Fulton Street, 34th Street, you get off that train, as soon as you look up, you look down, you look to your left, to your fucking right, you gonna see, don't get me wrong, you may see a pair or a hound out there. You know what I'm saying? The motherfuckers be out there. But don't get me wrong,
you also gonna see a lot of us. It's just gonna be us. This is our shit. Like, we run everything. Like, we determine who rocks. We determine what colors pop. We determine what cans to use. We determine what caps is good. We determine what lines, what stores pop. We determine everything graffiti. Our crew decides that shit in New York City. You know, when it comes to that social media shit, like, it don't got nothing to do with the influence of, like, who's up or not. You feel me? Because, like, social media don't determine who's up or not. Social media is just a way of saying, like, look, I'm up. Like, look, I'm up. That's it. It's not like if you get 100 fucking likes on social media, 1,000 likes on social media, that don't mean that you're up. You feel me? I know niggas that's up that only get, like, fucking 50 likes, 60 likes, but they're the most up niggas. They've been up since, like, fucking the 80s. You feel me?
The way you get up now has changed because pictures now play a much bigger role in the internet in terms of spreading your notoriety, your fame. Since graffiti writers all want notoriety from other graffiti writers, the internet is just perfect. I mean, it must drive law enforcement nuts.
I mean, that is graffiti. Like, that's how you get up now on social media. Or some people. That, I mean, but that's how it is. Like, you can fake an entire career on social media. But you could do that in any forum, you know, in fashion and art or whatever. You know what I mean? It's all smoke and mirrors. It's not just unique to graffiti.
I think it's kind of made graffiti secondary to a lot of people. You know, it becomes a lot more of, you know, I have this many followers on Instagram or on this or that, rather than I have this many tags up. And that's just kind of weird, you know, especially coming from something that was created out of something that you wanted to do.
Some people want to see it in the street themselves, you know. It's kind of like spoiling it sometimes, you know. A picture's cool too, but when you drive by a spot that you really, you know, you really demolished, it looks different in person. It's not the same. You don't feel it at all, you know?
I think it's a lot of to do with, like, fads. Like, everyone becomes, like, the it person at the time or whatever, but I think it should be just based on consistency and or talent or something more than likes on a picture.
It also makes the scene more accessible. It also makes more people do it, which I don't know if that's a good thing or not. You ask all the writers, they say no.
Graffiti and social media go hand in hand. Like, without social media, a lot of these graffiti writers wouldn't even be here. And with social media, a lot of these graffiti writers shouldn't be here.
I take advantage of that to put all my stuff out there, you know, to put my work out there. You know, I go to graffiti sites. I just like to upload my stuff everywhere I go, you know, I mean, every site I visit, you know, just to, you know, put myself out there. But not really about me, but just putting the word of God, the salvation of Christ, you know, out there to rep the gospel and myself as a gospel graffiti artist.
It's nice to be able to get your name out there and show your artwork to people that never would see it. How's someone in Italy or Europe going to see my shit? I don't travel. They're not going to see it if it wasn't for the internet. So that aspect, I think it's cool, is that people that would never be exposed to you are exposed to you. But again, I think it also makes people's heads a little fucking inflated that they think they're bigger than what they are.
Most of the graffiti stuff I see, like, lately is people going at it with other people, people talking shit about other people, people throwing subs. And that shit is corny. And it's like, I feel like when I discovered, like, the internet and graffiti, I was just researching, like, how to fuck with certain inks, how to make a fucking, like, a mini extinguisher without using an extinguisher, shit like that. And then I go on now, and it's like, it's just a big popularity contest. And it's just a bunch of small-minded people competing for a throne that doesn't actually exist.
It is what it is, you know what I'm saying? I guess it's for the level-headed.
Oh. Why do you clean it up?
Because I got to clean it.
He's got, no.
How do you feel about cleaning it up, though?
It's nice. Tell him how.
I don't feel no way about cleaning it up because it's part of our community. So, if anything to make our community look good, why not do it?
You don't like graffiti, like when you see it and stuff?
Nah, I like it, but you can't just go around putting it on everybody's property.
Mm-hmm. What about you? I mean,
if it's an artist's work and it doesn't make any problems with tags for gangs and pornography, I like some graffiti. But the ones like we just took off here, not good at all.
Okay. And do you mind telling me who you work for?
Right there in the truck. See it on the side of the truck?
Show y'all niggas how to dispose of sand. Spit on the cat. Spit on the cat. What? Fucking big blow.
Dog like what?
Yo.
Yo.
At ease. Back where you supposed to be. P, put it back where it's. Yo.
Yo,
at ease, back where you supposed to be. P, put it back where it's supposed to be.
Yo,
at ease, back where you supposed to be. P, put it back where it's supposed to be. Supposedly, niggas coming close to me. Trash rap niggas can't fuck with D. Exalted, affluent lifestyle. I kick calm shit that make your lava spread wanna harm shit. Don't be alarmed when the guns bang. It's only natural for my guns to hurt something. Cop a squad though, you might learn something. We giving out back braces and arm slings. Reality rap, the only song I sing. Nothing fugazi, strictly the real thing. Live in the flesh, my niggas fresh out the bang bang. Catch me in the click, in the spot every day. Lori guzzle, Chris, I down, nay, nay. Call it for you knock, knock the way. Wait, every it's like a new fight take place.
No doubt.
Hey, yo, Nas. Fuck that nigga, what nigga, say, they yo, no, tell me any
the
infamous QB houses where niggas stand out all night and make thousands. What you rap?
I rap when niggas get buried. Every fight dirty and stay hungry. So what you rap? Dying.
QB, we like to blow faces and pop slugs and your illest yeah. Niggas
yeah. Yeah. Gotta be sick of you. Black magic like food.
Yo. As I start from scratch about this born suspect named Neek, a street legend, pulling hits was his infatuation. From birth, his first spoken word was tech, so by the age of 12, you can guess what would dominate his conversation. He had a twin brother born to Nepal, one was dark, one was light, neither was right. Taking turns letting off shots to move crowds with the needle point aim and the infrared sight, so they ruled the night. His tone arm stayed tipped with the nickel plated, so even in the crossfire, they were never faded. It was debated that the steel plate was over. But they negated all competitors and tried to state it.
The jetpack is changing the whole fucking thing, you know?
Back in the days, motherfuckers will use a 16-foot ladder just to get to the spot, you know what I'm saying? We wasn't fucking bringing the shit onto the spot with us, you feel what I'm saying? Nowadays, niggas are bringing the fucking ladders onto the spots with them and using it to float, you know what I'm saying, above everybody else that been on the roof for like fucking 20 years and shit like that.
Serious-minded graffiti writers get good very quickly now. Whereas someone's toy period, like from them trying to be a painter until where they actually get really good at it, might take 5, 6, 7 years. Now it's months for a dedicated person. It's months to, and now there's complete how-to videos. I mean, I had a graffiti writer had to teach me how you do your original outline, you know what I'm saying? And then, you know, how you, you know, you build onto that with a you fill it in. I mean, you know, now there are videos out there that show you the complete process to become a painter or a graffiti writer.
Maybe like the late 80s, early 90s, you know, they kind of cleaned up the subway graffiti, and a lot of the writers at that time are already getting older, moved from subways out into the streets, and you know, more street bombing, more highways, more rooftops, and it was still the same, you know, objective: get fame, get your name out there, and become famous in a culture that nobody gave a shit about. Yeah.
So I think it's just a lot more accepted. You see it in commercials, in advertising. It's not as underground as it was, where originally it was underground. Now it's like, you know, everyone's doing it.
It's amazing to see how it was almost like not thought of, that it was like, it was basically, you know, a major crime to some people, to now being accepted into like advertising. It's crazy to see that whole just progression.
Graffiti is ever evolving, and it's very difficult to paint now than it was 15 years ago. There's cameras everywhere, there's cell phones, cell phone cameras. Like, it's incredibly dangerous to paint now, and you really have to be like on your shit to paint now, and it was much more of like a free-for-all back in the day. And so, hey, they're painting over here, and then somebody would like have to hear it like in their apartment building, look out the window, and then like call the police. Like, it's just, you know, somebody takes a picture that could like haunt you. It's very hard to paint now. So I mean, that has changed the whole like landscape of graffiti. Meanwhile, they're fucking painting out there, so God bless, you know?
When I was a kid, you know, my 20s, whatever, there'd be one graffiti show, like, every few months. Like, there would, like, be lucky if there were, like, 10 graffiti shows a year. Now you have 10 a week. You know, it, like, really grew. You know, the gallery scene grew a lot, and they became real graffiti and street art friendly, the galleries. It's a big movement. It's a big art movement today. As it was, you know, it was always growing, you know, from the 80s, from, you know, the Star Wars era to now. But the internet played a big part in that, too. You know, and then everybody wants to come to New York.
You know, friendliness of it. It wasn't always, you know, a friendly meeting when you met other writers back in the days. It was more aggressive. It was a street art, and it was just like, if you went to a layup or a tunnel and you had paint and you were there by yourself and three other guys show up, guess who's leaving that tunnel with no paint?
But now it's just speed of things that happen, and, you know, work that's put in needs to be put out right away, as if, you know, some people want to see it in the street themselves. You know, it's kind of like spoiling it sometimes, you know. A picture's cool too, but when you drive by a spot that you really, you know, you really demolished, it looks different in person. It's not the same. You don't feel it at all, you know.
I'm not taking pictures. Cover your face if you need to. Yeah, no, basically, like, who do you guys look up to? Who did you guys grow up, you know, like, admiring as graffiti writers?
Big writers like Noxer, Scuff, JAKEE, BG,
yeah.
Rest in Peace. You know, just everybody, you know?
Yeah.
I grew up in the street just looking at this art, and, you know, I just wanted... I looked up to people like that. I wanted to do the same thing as they do. And I always wondered how they do it. And once I found out how to, I went out there and did it myself.
Right. Okay. And like, what do you think about graffiti in New York?
I think it's art, but there's a lot of toys now. A lot of toys.
Yeah?
New writers that are whack. They're not good at all. They come and they destroy everything. They don't keep count. Somebody's old school. There's been a piece there for 20 years. They come, they take it out. They don't care.
What about you?
I love it.
Why do you love it?
I just love destroying shit all over the city and everything.
How long have you guys been tagging or doing graffiti?
About 10 years.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Who would you say is like pretty much killing shit now?
Honestly, the whack writers. I hate to say it.
Yeah.
There's a lot of whack writers coming out here.
What did you say?
The new one, like the little kids. It's like 12-year-olds, they come up and like they think they got it and then they just over it, like old pieces and shit.
Okay. Alright, would you mind telling me what you got, what you write?
I'm a
okay, what about you? Okay. Alright.
He's the one who's doing it. I can see him through the wall. I can see his face. See that face ever outside the ring.
That street art shit, I don't even know what that is. I don't even know what it is. You know what I mean? I'm gonna keep it a band with you. But what is that? Like, do they use pastels? Or do they use spray paint? They use spray paint and shit?
Like, when did it become street art? When did they go from graffiti to street art? Because I always saw, like, people doing pieces, people doing, like, murals, burners and stuff like that on the train. That's art, and that's out in the streets. But it wasn't street art, it was graffiti.
Seeing graffiti up as street art, but it's just a way for them to decriminalize it, make it a little more, you know, accepted, you know, oh, you know, street art. It's always been graffiti, you know, I consider that art in the street. Some people put actual physical art in the street, maybe that's street art. But for the most part, I just think it's a manufactured name just to make acceptance for it and, you know, let everybody under the sun start doing it, you know.
I mean, I think a lot of the writers have a problem with street artists because the reality is they're just not that talented. So when all you can do is your four letters, you don't want to see someone like doing this awesome artwork where I'm just not threatened by what other people do. Like I said, if it's illegal, it's graffiti. If you have permission, you have permission. It's not graffiti, even though it might look like graffiti.
The real definition of street art by me is getting up by any means necessary, applying your expressive thing, whether it's a word, a letter, a picture, an image, a bump, a splat. Expressing yourself on the street with your art illegally can be defined as street art to me. Mural art would be permission.
A part of me wants to have tolerance for street art because, like, at the end of the day, like, they're just trying to make it too. But also, like, I feel like with street art, there's just so much about their local community that they don't understand. Like, for example, in the South Bronx, we have, like, a mural of some, like, orca, like a killer whale. Like, this isn't fucking SeaWorld. This is the South Bronx. Like, why is this here?
I think there's a really big difference, but I think now that it's become so commercialized that people are not seeing the difference anymore.
A lot of artists have found that if you combine certain types of art and combine it with graffiti, you get that notoriety quickly. You know, and I like street art. Like, I love seeing neck faces, hairy arms. You know what I'm saying? I love seeing when Rambo does something crazy. I love that stuff. I mean, it's not graffiti. I mean, it's not traditional graffiti. I wouldn't call it graffiti. It's using material. Some street art is graffiti, though. You know, even though they're not doing letters, they may be doing characters. It really is. It really depends on the street artist. But because I have an appreciation for art, yeah, it doesn't really matter to me what medium they're using a lot of graffiti writers are basically, in my opinion, are jealous because street art is more accessible to the general public. It tends to be more accessible, whereas letters and stuff like that are, you know, much harder for the general public to get into. They have already negative sort of ideas of what graffiti is and stuff like that, where street art, you know, because it's not based on letters usually, it comes from a different space, so it has more commercial viability in the gallery scene. It's much easier to sell a smiley face on a canvas than someone with some kind of mechanical letter. It might be dope, I might like it, but you know what I'm trying to say, it's harder to sell that, you know.
I mean, if you did illegal stuff first and you put your work in as far as trains and everything else is concerned, no problem. Like Beak and Diva, they put their work in hard, they did their duty. So whatever they do now is all okay. But as far as like, if you're just up and coming and you're doing both, I personally don't think it's a good look, me personally, because you gotta pay your dues first. And a prime example is Giz. Giz paid his dues, went all city, did a lot of shit, and now he's doing his legal and whatever else he's doing, and that's okay as far as I'm concerned, because he did it, he paid his dues. So I don't have any problems with it, but I personally am all about just bombing.
When you look at it, 90% of these walls and murals and stuff like that wouldn't be done by street artists if graffiti wasn't there. One of the biggest selling points to a lot of these guys is they'll go to the building owner and say, well, you know, you got all this graffiti all over your building. Let me do a nice picture for you. So if it wasn't for the graffiti, then those murals probably wouldn't exist.
If you're a street artist, like if you're just painting in the streets, period, like, know your history about New York City and about graffiti, you know, and about writers that were doing it before you.
It comes in all flavors. Street art is not just graffiti. Street art could be anything. You know what I'm saying? It could be somebody drew a banana on a wall, or it could be somebody drew painting a Mona Lisa. You know what I'm saying? Anything that's on the wall, even if it's a paste, it's street art.
I feel that street artists tend to focus more on subject and, you know, ideas and concept of what thoughts or whatever ideas they're trying to put out, whereas graffiti artists primarily focus on their name. You know, it's just shameless self-promotion.
I don't have any issues with street art. I just think that street art and graffiti are two different things. And I think I'm an artist and I'm a graffiti writer, but I don't consider myself a street artist because I don't go into the street and put art. I go into the street and put graffiti.
What are some changes you would love to see in graffiti as a whole?
I love that question. I want everything to go back to fucking 90. I want to see fill-ins everywhere. Big fat tags on everything. I want to see everything dirty. I want to see dirty cities. I want everything to look the way New York looked back in the 80s. I want everything to look like fucking Detroit, Puerto Rico. I want dirty. I want dirt. That's, to me, real graffiti.
People getting more creative, tired of just seeing the same old repetitive stuff from people. You know, you've been doing it for how long? Let's just embrace the art itself, just characters, just go crazy with it. You know, you have, if you have time to get up there, just do the best you can.
The big dogs right now need to help motivate this generation. That's what I want to see. Not, oh, I'm too good to shake his hand because he's a toy. Why not shake the toy's hand and untoying him? Why not show him some styles? He's looking up to you.
It's just unfortunate that, like, none of the talent that existed here so historically that is renowned all over the world and all over, like, the history of this culture hasn't been spread down to the younger generations. New York City graffiti today is very different, and I don't think it's in line with what they originally had planned or envisioned for it in the 60s, the 70s, the 80s.
You know, New York City has a rich history of graffiti art, you know? It would be cool that, you know, the younger writers come up and they come up under that and see, like, all right, this person put in work, that person put in work. Not like, hey, I caught a couple of tags and, you know, now I'm the man, you know what I mean? Like, settle down, man, you know? It's like, you know, there needs to be an order of operations and things. And I feel like back in the day, we kind of had that. You know, you had your old school dudes who was painting the trains, then you had some younger cats who would come up under them and kind of like learn the tricks of the trade and learn the craft and go from there. Now it's just like, you know, you got a lot of chaos. You got a lot of people coming up, you know, younger people, less, you know, less experienced, less skilled, going over like more experienced, more determined, and more people who kind of put in work and more legends in this, you know, New York City graffiti game. So
I don't like young writers going over people that obviously have like 5 or 10 years plus on them. You know what I mean? I respect you going hard, but like if somebody's been putting work on you, you gotta like, you have to know to like respect your boundaries. You know what I mean? Cause that's from the beginning. That goes back to trains, you know?
You really gotta respect the dead. And I've seen people do floaters on spots that were rocking 20 plus years above someone who passed. And like, there's never gonna be a chance for him to come back and reclaim his spot or make it look good again. And it's just like, it's ugly.
One thing I wanna say about Brooklyn right now that I'm mad about is that people don't hit the new buildings. I wanna see the new buildings crushed. I wanna see them get targeted.
More originality, people from New York creating their own style instead of trying to write and do fillings and throw ups looking like they're from the West Coast. You know, going outside and co-signing these dudes that come from, you know, West Bumblefuck that ain't even from New York, taking over our space and our walls, you know.
Maybe not be so closed-minded about graph either, because, yeah, there's rules to graph, but it would be cool if, you know, people were more open about writing, like I said, like messages or doing characters or, you know, but also just like coming together as one community, not, you know, not just beefing with each other all the time. And because it can be really competitive, but that's good too. You know, competitiveness is good, but also, you know, if you're disrespecting people and you know, and you're hiding behind a name, you know, it's, to me, it's kind of gay, I don't know.
Like a lot of just negativity. That's the only thing that I would like to see change, because, you know, it's bad enough that a young kid could be walking down the street, an 8-year-old or a 7-year-old, and they gotta read this nonsense. You know, like the DI word, the DIC, I don't wanna say, or the, you know what I'm saying? All the Nazi signs, all the SMUT, you know, all this negative stuff that I see that's annoying. I hope that changes, man. That needs to stop, because that's straight up, that's unedifying, and it's not healthy for people to see.
I'm not unhappy about it. I mean, obviously, I would prefer probably more pieces, you know, and stuff like that. Younger artists doing, you know, trying to elevate the art form, but that's okay too, because I'm okay with the street bombing. I did it. I can't sit here and say, oh, that's bad. You know, tagging on walls and this is bad, because I was part of who I was or I am, you know. if I had the ability to go out there and do it without having cops come in here, I would do it.
Definitely going to modify itself, has already has. It will continue to evolve, but someone's always going to be putting their name up somewhere. It's just, it's been here forever. The idea of someone putting their name up to be remembered has just been here forever, so it's not going anywhere.
Would you stop?
Never. Never.
I know I never will, you know. I know that's for sure, but I definitely would like to, you know, would like to stop writing for a little bit.
Like, I'm not gonna stop painting illegally, but like it's always been, I'm in control of what I hit. I'm in control of what I paint and what I do. So, whenever I feel like in the spot, like, I'll go do it. If I see something, I'll go do it. You know, but I'm not like how I used to be. Like, oh, I have to go paint something today. Nah, it's not.
So, like, what's your mom here always doing? You always gonna want to catch a tag. You always gonna have a pen and a long board. Climb into a bathroom. You know, you wanna see the spot. You wanna see on the top. You know, especially now.
For me, I don't think anytime soon I'm gonna stop. And I don't wanna stop, and I don't know. I think I'll take breaks though. I know I'll take breaks. I've been taking a break. And I start again and I go crazy and it's great. And then I don't get bored, I just, life happens, you know?
Do you see yourself stopping anytime soon?
Nah, I love this shit. I do this for the love, like, this is my shit. Some people collect coins, I do graffiti, you know?
I could say, yo, I quit tomorrow, but 5-10 years from now, I'll see somebody bombing it and make me want to grab my 45-year-old ass out to go pay too, you know?
Yeah.
So.
Do you want to continue to pay?
It's not about wanting, you have a choice at this point, right?
I agree.
Yeah.
I don't want to quit, I don't feel, you know, close to quitting or anything like that, and it's been, you know, one of the highlights of my 20s, you know, to be able to like enjoy this sport and enjoy all the ways that like I've grown. So, you know, but yeah, eventually I hope to move on from this and find fulfillment in other ways. And like,
I'll keep painting graffiti as long as I want to do it, and as long as I get enjoyment from it.
I don't think I'd ever quit. I think I've already slowed down substantially. I just don't, unfortunately, have the energy I had when I was 20. I like my life, and you know, I'm just not willing to like take the risks I was willing to take 15, you know, even 10 years ago at this point. So I don't think I'll ever quit. I think it's in my blood, but I'll definitely have slowed down and probably will continue to slow down. But I will always leave the house for something that's worthwhile, or if I see a nice spot and have a candle, and you know, I will have to write on something. I just can't, I can't help myself. So I don't see myself ever quitting, no.
You know, it's just something that's in you, and once it's in you, you go for it all out or nothing.
Honestly, I wouldn't, man. I wouldn't want to stop, you know, I'm not planning to stop, but I'll plan to slow down, you know, maybe for a bit, just take a break, you know, here and there, but you know, I'll never stop, man.
I have stopped doing it, and then I started doing it, and then I stopped doing it, and then I started doing it. And I think it's something that I would always say is a part of my thought process, a part of the way I look at things. Graffiti is an essence. It embodies me. It isn't who I am, and it isn't what I do. It's just the thought, it's the idea, it's the energy behind it. I've learned from some of the greatest. I've seen some of the worst. I've helped people and they've helped me along the way. It is something that I will never forget, and the people who I've interacted with, they will never forget. And when we're not here anymore, whether I caught another tag or expressed myself, it doesn't matter because the times were had. I already am graffiti. I already done it. It's who I am. It's not what I do tomorrow that defines what makes me. It's what I've done so far, and I've done so much of that shit. It's in my blood. It's everything I do. I do it enough to know not to do it. Not to do it as much as I should be doing it.
My bad.
That's you.
Oh, that's cool. Now you're getting the beat. Hold on. Now you're getting the beat.
What?
Soft fire, call me. What? Right, hold that.
What?
It's like this. I'm gonna spill a little graffiti rap for y'all niggas. 1, 2, 3, yo. Walk down the street, find something to write on. Black rusto in the sleeve of my right arm. All these drips in my clothes, but I ain't no painter. Nigga, I'm a bomber, hold me down like an anchor in a party, popping tags in your crib. It's Jock 1, BMS, DC, what it is, I got a bad habit, niggas like what happened. When I'm in a jail cell, got caught for racking. See it, I like it, but I don't wanna pay for it. I throw it down the leg, yo, that's every day for him. Yo, I steal anything from car parts, food, clothes, or anything at Walmart. Shit is crazy, baby, but I like the thrill. Insane in the membrane like Cypress Hill. The car ride low trunk full of black cans and them little toys, yo, they all get the backhand. DC, don't care, fuck what you heard. BMS 104, 7-3rd, you know? I hear niggas talk about me, but they don't know me. If you wanna push my set, get your bitch to blow me. Niggas talk about beef, but they don't want more. Fucking rock a whole feeling on your front door and write your government. You don't want it, nigga. The whole sound of you, nigga, straight thugging it.
Oh my god!
Yo.